बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। एनिमल डाइवर्सिटी 1 लेक्चर 7 क्लास 2 में ट्रिगोफोरा एंड इट्स मेंबर्स लाइक क्लोरोप्लास्ट, सो दे आर हेटरोट्रॉफिक, मोस्टली दे आर पैरासाइट्स, फॉर एग्जांपल ट्राइपैनोसोमा ब्रुसाई कॉम्प्लेक्स। ट्राइपैनोसोमा ब्रुसाई इंक्लूड्स ट्राइपैनोसोमा ब्रुसाई ब्रुसाई दैट इज पैरासाइट ऑफ नॉन ह्यूमन मैमल्स ऑफ अफ्रीका, देन ट्राइपैनोसोमा ब्रुसाई गंबियन्सी दैट इज parasite in humans, cause sleeping sickness through that sexy fly. Then Trypanosoma brucei rhodesiense, that cause sleeping sickness in humans, same with the sexy fly. And these all three are also called the Trypanosoma brucei complex. Zoomastigophora, it is the animal that have the flagellum and parasitize higher animals. Best known zooflagellate is Trypanosoma. Here is Trypanosoma brucei, that is a cytoplasmic animal with free flagellum and attached flagellum. So there are two flagellum, two parts. Infection. Trypanosoma, it picks up the parasites from the blood and multiply asexually in the gut of the fly for 10 days, then migrate to salivary glands. Trypanosoma transform within 15 to 35 days, and when the infected sexy fly bites then to another vertebrate, then parasite travel with salivary secretions into blood host and where multiply asexually, then live in the blood, lymph, spleen, central nervous system and cerebrospinal fluid. Here is a sexy fly with the Trypanosoma. Salivary glands are there and Trypanosoma in the blood vessels. So if sexy fly bites the human infected with Trypanosoma, then this sexy fly will go into the salivary gland and then the blood vessels. Symptoms. In sexy fly bite or sleeping sickness, symptoms will be general apathy, general health issues will be there. The patient will become mentally retarded, mental dullness, and they cannot move. Their coordination will be very poor. They cannot speak, not move. And if patient has a malnutrition, so his diet is not proper, and also weakened condition, then heart failure will become the symptom, and sleepiness will develop. Now these all conditions will lead to death. If easily it is judged, then will be curable, but in advanced recovery is unlikely. If you know about the sleeping sickness in the advanced stage, then no benefit. Subphylum Sarcodina, that is Pseudopodia and amoeboid locomotion. Subphylum Sarcodina. Amoeba that often use Pseudopodia for food capture and locomotion can be naked, construct a shell or particles, or secrete a shell. Subphylum Sarcodina. Members of these phylums are amoeba, having the Pseudopodia involved in the feeding and movement. Pseudopodia types. Pseudopodia exist in variety of form that includes the Lobopodia, Phyllopodia, Reticulopodia, Exopodia. Lobopodia are basically the broad processes containing ectoplasm and endoplasm both and used for locomotion and engulfing of the food material. Then Phyllopodia. Phyllopodia contain only ectoplasm and they provide the two-way constant stripping movements. Then deliver food in a conveyor belt fashion. Exopodia are thin filamentous supported by central axis of microtubules. Cytoplasm covering the central axis is adhesive and movable. So it can stick. Food got delivered to the central plasma of the amoeba or central cytoplasm. Superclass Rhizopoda, class Lobosia. The most familiar amoeba belong to this class Lobosia and genus Amoeba. They are naked, so they have no shell. They live in the shallow water, not in the deep water of the freshwater ponds, lakes, slow moving streams, and feed on the protists and bacteria. They eat the food by phagocytosis. So they engulf the large bulk of food by phagocytosis, and they reproduce by binary fission. So their body divides into two parts and no sexual reproduction. Here is amoeba. Pseudopodia is their nucleus, endoplasm, ectoplasm, and phagocytic vacuoles, contractile vacuole also there. Tests are protective structures that are connected to the cytoplasmic secretes, calcareous, maybe calcium carbonate in the composition, proteinaceous, maybe made up of proteins, siliceous, maybe made up of silicon dioxide, chitinous, may be made up of chitin and composed of sand, sometimes also like siliceous, and sometimes debris cemented into a secreted matrix. Here is the cytoplasmic strands attached to the shell and shell. Body is inside. Then subphylum Actinopoda, foraminiferans, heliozoans, and radiolarians. This diagram is radio RN. Foraminiferans. These are group of amoeba with shell, and foraminiferans commonly called forams. They possess reticulopodia, secrete a shell made up of calcium carbonate, so calcareous shell. Then large chambers that remain attached to the older chamber. It means that the shell grows as the animal grows, and the newer shell will be larger. The older shell will be smaller, and newer shell will get attached to the older chambers. Testinal larvae follow a symmetrical pattern, and marmot penis is an example. Here are foraminiferans. So you can see the stepwise extension of the shell. They don't have the live animals. Now these are only the shells. Heliozoans are aquatic amoeba. They are planktonic, so flow in the water, or sometimes attached by a stalk to some substrate. Naked, there is no shell, and sometimes test that contain openings for exopodia. Here are heliozoans having exopoda, ectoplasm, endoplasm, and food vacuoles. Radiolarians. Radiolarians are also planktonic like heliozoans and amoeba. They live in the marine water, sometimes in the fresh water, and their size is relatively large when they form the colonies, and their colonies are several centimeter in diameter. They possess test made up of siliceous. Foraminiferans have the calcareous, and they have siliceous. They have long movable spines, needles, or a highly sculptured ornamented rattles. When die, they just drift to the ocean floor. This is radiolarian. That is inner shell, outer shell, and growth. Then phylum Labyrinthomorpha. The very small phylum Protozoa with spindle shaped, and they are non-amoeboid vegetative cells, typically gliding movement within a network of mucus tracts. Live in the marine environment. They are saprozoic, and living in saprozoic are those who feed on the dead organisms and sometimes parasites on the algae and seagrass. Labyrinthomorpha. Labyrinthola is an example. Thank you.